I'm Marc, and I'm the head developer of the new M32 AD Pro and the new M32 DA Pro. These units are the newest multi-channel converters from RME. Compared to the old M32, what is obvious is the difference from the outside. We now only have one head unit instead of two, and we have a lot of space dedicated to the channels and channel indicators, and this is for a reason. Usually these devices are back in the machine room, and if you open the door looking at the rack, you want to know immediately what's going on. And if you open the door from like 10 meters away, you still see what's going on. You see the levels, you see if there's signal, if it's clipping, if the signal is too hot, whatever. Another thing is the soundness. If there is something wrong with the system, you want to know immediately. For example, let me mess with the setup. And I select a clock source which is not there. Then the power button starts blinking red, so you see there's something wrong. Then you can look further, where is the error, where is the issue, not only here on the display, but also on the web interface. And as soon as I select a valid clock source, which is in sync, everything goes green again. So what are these devices doing? They're converting from analog to digital, and on the digital domain, we have interface for MADI and also AVB. Why AVB? We think of AVB as a backbone, and if we choose a backbone technology, it should be rock solid, RME-like, and this is why we settle on AVB. With AVB, it's not only possible to deliver packets deterministically, but also to have a very precise clocking due to the fact that every switch is involved in the clocking process. And with audio networking, and AVB is no exception there, you have the possibility to have a very high channel count with very high resolution over one cable. This makes it possible for the M32, for example, to get all the 32 channels at a high sample rate of 192 kHz over one Ethernet cable. But not only the outer appearance changed, but also the technology inside. In the M32, we have the newest generation AKM converters with excellent audio quality. We have very low noise, down to minus 120 dB, and also very, very low distortion, THD. Each channel can be configured individually for the level reference plus 13, plus 19, or plus 24 dBU, and all channels are truly symmetrical. You can control the device via the display, and it lets you control all functionality. And if you don't have access to it, we put a web interface into it. With the web interface makes it possible to remote control the device from anywhere on the network. For the remote control, by the way, it doesn't matter if it's an AVB network or not. It can even be routed. The web interface provides controls for every device function and also monitoring capabilities to give you an overview of the device status. You see the large level meters, which makes it possible to monitor your signal and figure if there are any peaks. Underneath, there's the ability to name the channels. You can also set the analog gain reference, plus 13, plus 19, plus 24 dBU. Moreover, for the DA, which we see here, you can mute each channel individually or in groups. Of course, you can also do the internal routing via the web interface. It's not only possible to convert analog to MADI or analog to AVB, but also to use the M32 as a converter between MADI and AVB. To route it, you select, for example, the AVB output stream where the signal should going. Select a channel group, and then select the source. Now MADI optical 1-4, go to AVB second stream channel 1-4. You see that the routing has an automatic increment capability. This comes in handy if you want to route large groups, for example 64x64, then you can just go here without moving the mouse any further. And with the buses, you see here the 8 and the 7, you have an overview how many channels are routed from each port to each port. You also have the AVB status here, so here you see the stream ID, the destination MAC address, and if it's streaming, if it's disabled, or in case of an issue, what the issue exactly is. There is also a clock section, so you can choose your master clock and the correct sampling rate. And we have some additional features. For example, if the device is put on a stage and you don't want all the blinking and the lights, you can just switch them off here. We have redundant power supplies in the M32. And if one of them fails and you want to be notified about that, you hit that switch. All of these settings can be saved as a preset and reloaded here, but also on the display of the device. This web interface is based around a JSON API, and this JSON API is publicly available, so you can integrate the device in your own system. Also, all functions are available for remote control via the Open FDEC protocol, which is part of the AVB standard. The M32 AD Pro and the M32 DA Pro are perfect for studios with lots of analog gear or large analog consoles, as well as for digital archiving and spatial audio. Moreover, it's suited for industrial applications where you have the need to convert lots of digital of analog channels with high quality. The M32 Pro will be available in the UK in October. Find out more at synthax.co.uk.